Greetings, I'm Dave Gilmore, and this is Design Intelligence. At Design Intelligence, we've codified what we believe to be the five foundational essentials of effective leadership. Let me offer two of these. These are not the only attributes of an effective leader, but they are foundationally essential for any leader who leads people directly and indirectly. We begin with emotional maturity. Our definition of emotional maturity is being self-aware and focused on others. That is to say, one who is emotionally mature recognizes and affirms one's own strengths and gifts, while equally acknowledging one's own weaknesses and shortcomings in order to address them directly and meaningfully. Equally, the emotionally mature focus on those they lead to support, come alongside, coach and confront, and empower them to be the best they can be in the role where they are serving. Self-aware, focused on others. The opposite can be said of the emotionally immature. Such leaders are self-focused, sometimes self-obsessed. These are the ones who make it all about themselves. They talk over others, posture for recognition, insert noise at the end of dialogue to ensure theirs is the last word. Such are the sorts who are often obtuse to the true value of the people they lead. They miss the wonder of the multiple dimensions of talent resident within their organizations. People become a means to their end rather than the focus of their leadership attention. What kind of leader are you? Second, effective leaders operate from a center of approachability. Know what I mean? A great leader is always open to others. They invite the presence and input of others into their sphere. People get the clear signal that they're accepted and acceptable, and as such, they feel a freedom to approach this kind of leader. When leaders repulse others, it's very clear that input is unacceptable unless specifically asked for. The repulsive leader often lives behind closed doors or is fronted by an assistant to filter out unwanted interaction. When people get the message that their input is only valued when asked for, they will naturally withhold. They will pull back, hiding their insight and offered perspective, and this usually seeds resentment that over time undermines the positive possibilities that could have been achieved had the leader just been openly postured and approachable. What kind of leader are you? Both of these leadership essentials emanate from a common root. Both emotional maturity and approachability spring from self-acceptance. It's a big thing, you know. This value of self-acceptance is inestimable. Far too many people live on the other side of the coin from self-acceptance. Self-rejection is far more common and destructively rudders people's lives towards isolation, broken relationships, and lonely ineffectiveness. The journey to self-acceptance is well worth the effort and sets the basis for these two foundational elements of an effective leader. What kind of leader are you? Until next time, I'm Dave Gilmore, and this is Design Intelligence.